Superdome is ready to welcome Buckeye and Razorback fans. That's where we find 4029 Sports Director Mark Clericos and Derek Burleson. And it feels like a long time, huh, guys?
Yeah, absolutely, Craig. And really, still relatively quiet here in the Superdome, but rest assured, we're still over 2 hours from kickoff. Tens of thousands of Hog fans are going to be piling into this Superdome, getting ready for one of the biggest games of their lives. It's hard to understate just how amazing this season has been for Arkansas. Imagine 3 years ago, the natural state was fractured over the loss of Houston Nutt, and here we are 3 years later, sitting at a BCS game here in New Orleans. It has been an amazing reaction from Hog fans that we've talked to throughout the week. They couldn't be any more excited. Call it pure joy as we get ready for Arkansas and Ohio State. Let's bring in Chris Bahn from Arkansas Sports 360. Let's talk about the actual game here, Chris. A couple keys to the game. It's going to be a great one, we believe. Let's start first, though, with Knile Davis. Everybody talks about Ryan Mallett, but that running game could be key.
Yeah, you know, if you look at the six-game winning streak that Arkansas went on this year, Knile Davis was really the catalyst behind that. He ran for nearly 900 yards and 12 of his 13 touchdowns down the stretch. So they've got to get him going. That's going to take a little bit of pressure off of Ryan Mallett. Definitely they need Knile Davis to run well to have a chance to win the game.
And of course, for the Hog defense, the key is going to be starting with Terrell Pryor, containing him and keeping him from getting loose and making all kinds of magic happen.
Yeah, you know, and he's a guy that's, you know, widely regarded across the country as one of the best quarterbacks in the country, dual threat. Arkansas has faced a lot of those guys this year, but, you know, you hope that they can defend him like they did Jordan Jefferson of LSU, the Texas A&M quarterback, Gerard Johnson, you know, as opposed to what they did against Cam Newton, who really tore him up. Even Jeremiah Masoli was trouble for them. So they've got to really contain him and not let him get off and running.
Yeah, Petrino has said several times, don't be hesitant like we were against Cam Newton because it costs them. And, of course, there's always phase three in a game of this magnitude. If it comes down to little stuff, special teams.
You know, it's not something we like to spend a whole lot of time talking about, the special teams, but it's an area where Arkansas has been really great and really bad at times this year. You know, Joe Adams has been really good with the punt returns. They don't necessarily need one of those for a touchdown, but if you look at what Wisconsin did in beating Ohio State, they were able to get big special teams play, and Arkansas can't afford to have the breakdowns they did throughout the season.
Great stuff from Chris Bahn of Arkansas Sports 360. He's been joining us all season and been covering the Hogs. Great stuff as always. Thank you. All right, Craig Cannon, Derek Burleson will be along in just a moment to talk about some of the Hog fans as well. They've been everywhere in New Orleans today and for the last few days. That's coming up in just a bit. But now, for now, live in the Superdome with the Hogs as we're counting down to the Sugar Bowl. Craig, let's send it back to you.
And the excitement is building. Okay, Mark, great job. Thank you.